In this problem, two people are having a tug of war on a frozen pond, and the whole point of that is that we can ignore friction in the problem. And I have one person with a mass of 80 kilograms, the other 62, and they're starting from rest. And we observe that the acceleration of the heavier person is 0.8 meters per second squared. They start 15 meters apart with the lighter person sitting at the origin. In part A, we're asked to get the acceleration of the 62 kilogram person. And this is really a force concept question. The strategy here is going to be, since we know the acceleration and the mass of the heavier person, we can find the force on them. Then we use Newton's third law to say, well, these people must exert forces on each other with equal magnitude and opposite direction. And then knowing the force on the lighter person and their mass, we can get their acceleration. So let's get started. We apply Newton's second law to the heavier person. And we're just talking about magnitudes here. We'll deal with directions in part B, where we have to use a minus sign for that person's acceleration. And their mass is 80 kilograms. And their acceleration is 0.8 meters per second squared. And this means that person is experiencing a horizontal force of 64 newtons. Then invoking Newton's third law, we know that when two objects are interacting, they exert forces on each other that are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So there must be a 64 newton force to the right on the lighter person. Another way to say it is that the tension in the rope is 64 newtons, and whether you feel the tension at the left end or the right end, it's going to be 64 newtons. This allows us to get the acceleration of the lighter person, A equals F over M, and that's 64 newtons over 62 kilograms, and we get 1.03 meters per second squared for the acceleration. In part B, we get the kinematics problem. We want to know the location where these two people run into each other. And one thing you should be checking for qualitatively is I know the acceleration of the smaller person is going to be a larger number. So when these two people crash into each other, it should be right of the midpoint, something bigger than 7.5 meters right of the origin. So the way we handle these kinematics problems where there's two objects moving is we use the standard equations for kinematics to write down a position versus time function for each person. And that's really just the first kinematics formula. So for the smaller person, provided the acceleration is constant, you can say x equals x naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. The initial velocity was given as 0. The initial position for that person is 0 because we put the origin there. And now I can write down their position as a function of time as 1/2 at squared, where a is 1.03. Now for the heavier person, same deal. That's our first kinematics formula in the standard list. And plugging in what we know, the position as a function of time for the second person, I'm going to go ahead and subscript these as little m and big M. It's given by an initial position of 15, and here's where the direction matters on the acceleration vector. I've got to put in a minus sign for that initial acceleration, so minus 1/2 times 0.8 t squared. Then to find the position where they crash into each other, I can just set these two equal to each other. In other words, I plug into the mathematics that the positions of the two objects are the same, and then I can solve for what time it is. I'll just go ahead and do that up here. And I'll go ahead and move all the t squared terms to the left-hand side, and I'm going to get a decimal approximation for the coefficient of t squared in the same step. That gives me 0.915 t squared is equal to 15. Then we divide by the coefficient of t squared and square root the result. And we're going to keep the positive answer here since the experiment started it at t equals 0. And I end up with a total time of 4.05. seconds. To wrap things up, I can now find the position of each of these people at 4.05 seconds, and I'm going to do both of them because that's a double check on my work. Both of them should have the same position at 4.05 seconds, and being in the same place at the same time is what a collision is. So xm, little m, evaluated at 4.05 is 1/2 times 1.03 times 4.05 squared, and I get a position of 8.45 meters right of the origin. That's past the halfway point, so that's encouraging. Then I do the same thing with the heavier person, X big M, evaluated at 4.05 seconds, is 15 minus 1 half times 0.8 times 4.05 squared. And I get 8.44 meters right of the origin. That's a small discrepancy that can be attributed to rounding error in the problem. And our two final positions agree, so we can have a high degree of confidence we've done everything correctly in the problem. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.